We solve the following three exponential equations on this video. We're going to solve equations of the form b to the x equals b to the y. So if the base b is greater than 0 and not equal to 1, and b to the x equals b to the y, then x equals y. That means we can make the exponents equal to each other. So that's the key. If the bases are the same, then the exponents are equal. Now, we can't always get an exponential equation in this form where the bases are the same. For instance, 3 to the x equals 2 to the x minus 1. We're sort of stuck there. 1 has a base of 3 and 1 has a base of 2. But if we can do it, if we can get something in this form, it's the method of choice for solving. So those are the kinds of problems we're going to work on in this video. So here's our first example. 2 to the x minus 3 equals 16. All right, notice I have a base of 2 on the left and a base of 16 on the right. You could think of this as 16 to the 1. What you want to know is you look at the bases and you want to see if you could write them as a power of some exponent, and hopefully the same one. Well, 2 is already prime, so you can't go down any further. So we have to leave this as 2 to the x minus 3. But 16, if you do a factor tree, you'll notice that's 2 to the 4th, and that's the key. You need to write that as a power of the lowest base, 2 to the 4th. And the hint is, since you're given a problem with a 2 for the other base, you're going to see if you can write 16 with a base of 2 as well. Now, the bases are the same, so that means that I can make the exponents equal. So that's the equation we have to solve. X minus 3 equals 4. So if we add 3 to both sides, that gives you x is 7. All right, so it looks like that's the answer, x is 7. But let's check. So our original was 2 to the x minus 3 equals 16. And we're just going to plug in 7 for x. So that's 2 to the 4th, which is 16. And yes, both sides are the same when you plugged in 7 for x. So that's our solution. X is 7, right? Or if you were going to write that using a solution set, you would say the solution is 7. Let's try another one. All right, how about this one? We have 9 to the negative 2x equals 27. Note, neither 9 nor 27 are prime. We want to see if we could write that as a power of something, and hopefully the base will be the same. Well, 9 is 3 squared, and 27 is 3 cubed, so 3 is going to be the base we want. So we need to rewrite 9 is 3 squared, but that's 3 squared 2, the negative 2x. And 27 would be 3 cubed. So I haven't quite got it in the form I want. I want to get it into just 3 to the something equals 3 to the something else. So now I have to use my laws of exponents here. I need to multiply the 2 times the negative 2x. So we have 3 to the negative 4x equals 3 cubed. And now I've got the same base, so the exponents are going to be equal. So negative 4x equals 3. Just divide both sides by 4. I'm sorry, divide both sides by negative 4. So x is negative 3/4. All right, so it looks like that's the answer, but of course we do want to check our answers. So let's do that. And I'm going to move this over to the left a little bit to give us a little bit more room for our check. All right, so we're going to check 9 to the negative 2x equals 27 by plugging in negative 3/4 for x. So we have 9 to the negative 2 times negative 3/4, right? Because we're doing negative 2 times x. So that's 9. Well, the negative times negative is positive. The 2 cancels. That gives me 3/2. And what does that mean? That means the square root of 9 cubed. which is 3 cubed, which is 27, and so it checks. Cool. So x equals negative 3 fourths is the correct answer. You could always check your answer, and if you were going to write it using a solution set, you would just put the braces around it. Let's do another one. All right, now we're going to do 8 to the x equals 1 fourth. Looks a little bit different because we have that fraction over on the right. And there's a couple ways you might start this problem. And in fact, if you want, you can try this on your own first. Okay, one way is say, well, I'd like them both to be, not looking like fractions here. So I could change this 1/4 to 4 to the negative 1. So that's an option. If you'd like to write 1/4 as 4 to the negative 1, you can do that for your first step. Now I'm going to take each base and write it with the same base to some power. So 8 is 2 cubed, so that's 2 cubed to the x. And 4 can be written as 2 squared, so that's 2 squared to the negative 1. Haven't quite got it in the form I need it yet. I have to use my laws of exponents, multiplying. 3 times x is 3x. And over here, the 2 times the negative 1 will be negative 2. Now that I have the same base, that's when you can make the exponents equal. So 3 halves equals negative 2. I'm just going to divide both sides by 3. So x is negative 2 thirds. So that's one option. Okay, side by side, somebody might not have started off by writing 1/4 as 4 to the negative 1. The other option is to go ahead and write 8 is 2 cubed, and write 4 as 1 over 2 squared. So you could begin by writing 4 as 2 squared, in other words. And then you'd have to realize that 1 over 2 squared is the same thing as 2 to the negative 2. And over on the left side, again, you're going to multiply the 3x, the 3 times x, so you get 2 to the 3x. Notice you end up with the same equation at this point. It's just that you started the problem a little bit differently. So I'm still going to end up with the same answer as x equals negative 2 thirds from this point on, because the next two steps will be as you see here. So it looks like x equals negative 2 thirds is the answer. So all we want to do is check that. So how about if I just do the check like this? The question really is 8 to the x equal to 1/4? So you could just check and make sure that x to the negative 2 thirds really is 1/4. So if I check that, first I have to remember that 8 to a negative number is 1 over 8 to the positive exponent, right? And then that would be 1 over, well, what is 8 to the 2 thirds? That's the cube root of 8 squared. So that is 1 over 2 squared, which is 1/4. So it's true that 8 to the negative 2 thirds does equal 1/4. You're just checking that that would be true. You would get the same number on both sides. So negative 2 thirds is the correct solution for x. And if you were going to write that using brackets, of course, you would just write it inside the braces. I said brackets, but I meant braces. My observation as a teacher is that most people never check their answers, but I strongly encourage you, no matter what problem you're doing, anytime you're solving an equation, that you go back and plug it in and make sure both sides are really the same number. In the end, it's up to you. A lot of people just look in the back of the book and say, was that the right answer? But you don't get that option when you're taking a test. So that's why I'm always taking the time to check my answer. All right, on the next video, I'll do a few more problems like this in case you need some more practice.